was born in the Bitterroot Valley in the early morning. Wild geese over the water and northern home again. Bringing a warm wind from the south, bringing a first taste of the spring. His mother took him to her breast and softly she did sing. Oh, ho, ho, Montana, give this child a home. Give him a love of a good family and a woman of his own. Give him a fire in his heart, give him a light. Denver wrote what he considered to be a trilogy of songs. And the first one he wrote to capture what it's like trying to find that right person, that one person to share his dream. And he never doubted his ability, ever, ever, ever. Before he was famous as John Denver, he played with the Mitchell Trio. And Chad Mitchell left the group to pursue a solo career, and they held auditions, and they auditioned 100 singer-songwriters, and John Denver got that job. And we'll talk a little bit more about that a couple songs down the road. But he was never in doubt about his ability. He was in a hotel in New York with a toothache, and he had $4.17 to his name. But not even enough money to go to the dentist at the time. But he wanted to find the right person who would share that vision with him to pursue the music as a career. And so this is the song that he wrote to maybe to speak to that person. It's by far the hardest thing I've ever done, to be so in love with you and so alone. Follow me where I go, what I do and who I know. Make it part of you to be a part of me. Follow me up and down, all the way and all around. Take my hand and say you'll follow me. It's long been on my mind, you know it's been a long, long time. I'll try to find a way I can make you understand the way I feel about you and just how much I need you. To be there where I can talk to you and there's no one else around. Sing with me. Follow me where I go, what I do and who I know. Make it part of you to be a part of me. Follow me up and down, all the way and all around. Take my hand and say you'll follow me. See, I'd like to share my life with you, show you things I've seen, places where I'm going to and places where I've been. To have you there beside me and never be alone. And all the time that you're with me, then we will be at home. Sing, follow me where I go, what I do and who I know. Make it part of you to be a part of me. Follow me up and down, all the way and all around. Take my hand and say you'll follow me. Take my hand and say you'll follow me. Thank you so much. I love that song. So that was the first of the trilogy, and now I'm going to play you the second, and I'm going to build the third song into the middle of it. And the second song, you're going to know this. In fact, you're going to it's going to be hard for you to restrain yourselves from singing along, because it's probably, this is true, this is true. This song actually has two copyrights, had two different titles, so it has to have two copyrights. And it's one of the songs that, if you're looking for a souvenir from tonight, it's on one of the CDs. It's, my lovely wife is manning the CD desk back there. John Denver actually played this song when he was part of the Mitchell Trio. The O'Shaughnessy Auditorium, the Mitchell Trio was playing there, and they were doing their sound check. And he actually played this song, and that was the first time she had heard it. Now, John Denver's first commercial album was called Rhymes and Reasons. If you had it or you see it, he's like wearing the Western shirt with a little kerchief and looking like Mr. Cute. But he actually had an album before that he self-produced. He made 250 copies of it. And it had songs on it like Blues My Naughty Sweetie Gives to Me. That one didn't make the charts. But he had another song on there, and he gave this record, one of the 250 copies, he gave it to Milt Okun. Now, Milt Okun was one of the judges when they were looking to replace Chad Mitchell. He was one of the judges who listened to all 100 singer-songwriters. And he really liked that song. He really liked one of the songs on that album. Now, it so happened that Milt Okun was also the producer for this trio. I'm not sure if you've heard of him, Peter, Paul, and something. Yeah, so he gave that song and it became Peter, Paul, and Mary's best-selling hit of all time. Now, the original title is Oh Babe, I Hate to Go. So if you ever can see a copy of that, or those 250, that's the title that it's given on the album. And Milt Okun said, you cannot call it Oh Babe, I Hate to Go. There's a much better lyric. Something about leaving on a jet plane. So you have to sing along with me on this one. But remember, we're going to take a right turn about two-thirds of the way through the song, to the third of the song. So listen, think about that. Leaving on a jet plane. It's hard to leave. It's hard to leave because I found that person. And then the relationship gets even more complicated in that third song. And you'll hear it and sing with all these words. Sing with all the songs. All my bags are packed. I'm ready to go. Standing here outside your door. Hate to wake you up. Say goodbye. Dawn is breaking, it's early morn. Taxi's waiting, he's blowing his horn. Already I'm so lonesome I can cry. So kiss me and smile for me. Tell me that you'll wait for me. Hold me like you'll never let me go. 'Cause I'm leaving on a jet plane. Don't know when I'll be back again. Oh, babe, I hate to go. There's so many times I've let you down. So many times I've played around. Tell you now, they don't mean a thing. Dream about the days to come when I won't have to leave alone. About the time I won't have to say. Oh, kiss me, smile for me. Tell me that you'll wait for me. Hold me like you'll never let me go. 'Cause I'm leaving on a jet plane. Don't know when I'll be back again. Oh, babe, I hate to go. It's 5 o'clock this morning and the sun is on the rise. Frosting on my window, pain and sorrow in your eyes. Stars are fading quietly and night is nearly gone. And so you turn away from me and tears begin to come. And it's goodbye again. I'm sorry to be leaving you. Goodbye again. As if you didn't know. Why do we always fight when I have to go? I have to go and see some friends of mine. Some that I don't know. Some that aren't familiar with my name. It's something that's inside of me. Not hard to understand. It's anyone who listens to me say. Let me kiss you, close your eyes, I'll be on my way. Dream about the days to come when I won't have to leave alone. About the time I won't have to say. Oh, kiss me and smile for me. Tell me that you'll wait for me. Hold me like you'll never let me go. I'm leaving on a jet plane. Don't know when I'll be back again. Leaving on a jet plane. Don't know when I'll be back again. Oh, babe, I hate to go. This one is completely by request. Somebody came up to me before the show started and said, this is my favorite John Denver song. Are you planning to play it tonight? And I said, you know, it's not early in our song list. But during our intermission, we kind of put our heads together and we're going to give this one a try. It might be a little bit dusty.
It'll be fine.
So this was a song about John Denver's very first true girlfriend. It's the first person that he dated that he could see himself settling down with, not settling for, that wasn't a good way to say it, settling down with, and having a child with. I mean, he could picture them walking together. This is a song for Baby for Bobby. I'll walk in the rain by your side. I'll cling to the warmth of your hand. I'll do anything to keep you satisfied. I'll love you more than anybody can. And the wind will whisper your name to me. Little birds will sing along in time. Leaves will bow down when you walk by. And morning bells will chime. I'll be there when you're feeling down, to kiss away the tears as you cry. A reflection of love in your eyes. And I'll sing you the songs of the rainbow, a whisper of the joy that is mine. Leaves will bow down when you walk by, and morning bells. Warmth of your tiny hand. I'll do anything to help you understand, and I'll love you more than anybody can. And the wind will whisper your name to me. Little birds will sing along in time. Leaves will bow down when you walk by, and morning bells will chime. So John Denver wrote what are considered to be two wedding type songs. Remember that time. This is the second one. This was also played at a lot of weddings. Cliff DeYoung did a TV show where this was part of the entry. It's got two introductions. I like the introduction from my favorite John Denver album is The Evening with John Denver. Blank. Thank you. Otherwise, I was like, I'm just looking at 99 blank stares. I was like, oh, yeah. No. So there's two of them. This is one. I like. Lady, are you crying? Do the tears belong to me? Did you think our time together was all gone? Lady, you've been dreaming. I'm as close as I can be, and I swear to you our time has just begun. Rest your weary mind. stay right here beside you. Today our lives were joined, came entwined. I wish you could know how much I love. Their meanings that you've never seen before. Lady, my sweet lady, I just can't believe it's true. And it's like I've never, ever loved before. Close your eyes and rest your weary mind. I promise I will stay right here beside you. Today our lives were joined, became entwined. I wish you could know how much I love you. Lady, are you crying? Do the tears belong to me? Did you think our time together was all gone? Lady, close as I can be, and I swear to you our time has just begun. So it came to pass, John Denver being like the ping pong ball going back and forth, trying to find acceptance with the country community, the folk community, never really fitting in anywhere. But the 1974 release of the album Back Home Again was considered in the running in 1975, because those are the way the rules work, for the Country Music Association Hall of Fame Country Album of the Year, and John Denver was nominated as the Country Artist of the Year. Yep. So, drum roll. I wasn't serious, but okay. This is good. So Charlie Rich is the guy on stage reading the results. So he opens up the envelope, and he pulls out the card and he reads, and the winner is Back Home Again and John Denver. And he was so incensed that John Denver had won, he reached into his back pocket, pulled out a cigarette lighter, lit that ballot on fire, dropped it on the stage of the Ryman Auditorium, and walked off. Absolutely true. Absolutely true. So that was kind of the beginning of the decline of Charlie Rich's career. And he kind of walked it back. You can read it in the history books. He walked it back as he was suffering from too much something or not enough of something and some substance or some, I don't know. He tried to walk it back, but it just did not fly at all. But that was John Denver's world. I mean, to have so many best-selling albums, but to not get the respect of his fellow musicians, it was just kind of a shame. It's hard for me to actually, you know, we have the country music stations all over surrounding us, and it's hard to imagine John Denver's music fitting in even now with that. But he did sing what I think is a country song. He didn't write it. A guy named Dick Fellers actually wrote this next song. But to me, it is the most country-sounding album or song that John Denver ever did. And I think it's kind of a fun song. It's called Some Days Are Diamonds. So you like this song?
Yeah.
Okay, so we're going to sing this one. Well, you ask how I've been here without you. I'd like to say I've been fine, and I do. But we both know the truth is hard to come by. And if I told the truth, you know that's not quite true. Some days are diamonds, some days are stones. Sometimes the hard times, they won't leave me alone. Sometimes the cold in my bones. Some days are diamonds, some days are stone. Now the face that I see in the mirror, more and more he's a stranger to me. More and more danger in becoming who I never thought I'd be. Some days are diamonds, some days are stones. Sometimes the hard times, they won't leave me alone. Sometimes a cold wind blows a chill in my bones. Some days are song. I think that really sounds much more like a country song that John Denver would sing. But I thought maybe we'd just give it a little extra kick of country. So something like this. Some days are diamonds, some days are stones. And you never even called me by my name. That was fun. Apologies to David Allen Coe. So, a little bit more about John Denver. Tumultuous life. If you want to maintain your image of John Denver, wholesome, clean-cut country boy, do not read his autobiography. He is brutally honest in print about his infidelities and his drug use, and now I've spoiled the plot for you. But he really lays it out on paper, how confused and the tumultuous life that he had. The ups and the downs, the on again, off again with Annie, and the second marriage to the Australian actress, and that lasted 3.5 years. But throughout, you read these documentaries, you read the books, you see that there's a couple of things that just stayed absolutely constant, that never varied in his message, in his songs, in his life. It's like a two phrases that I think capture it. He said, take care of the earth and take care of each other. That was his central message. I was talking during the break with a young woman who was in Africa when John Denver went, way before it was fashionable to raise awareness and money for food for the starving African children. And she had a chance to chat with him extensively and just how wonderful that was for her. That's the kind of guy that he was. Take care of the earth and take care of each other. Now, he wrote a song that I think captures that better than any book could ever, and his biography could do. It's a song that he put on his 17th album. He released it in 1983. Maybe you've heard this, maybe you haven't. It's a song called It's About Time. There's a full moon over Africa, and Gandhi lives again. Who's to say you have to lose for someone else to win? In the eyes of all the people, look is much the same. For the first is just the last one. When you play a deadly game, it's about time we realize it. We're all in this together. It's about time we find out it's all of us or none. It's about time we recognize it. These changes in the weather. It's about time. It's about changes. It's about time. There's a light in the Vatican window for all the world to see. And a voice cries in the wilderness. Sometimes he speaks for me. Loves him most when he kneels to kiss the lamb. With his lips upon our mother's breast, he makes his strongest stand. It's about time we start to see it. Earth is our only home. It's about time we start to face it. We can't make it here all alone. It's about time we start to listen to these voices in the wind. It's about time. It's about changes. It's about time. There's a man who is my brother. I just don't know his name, but I know his home and his family, cause I know we feel the same. And it hurts me when he's hungry, and it hurts me when his children cry. I too am a father, and those little ones are mine. It's about time we begin it, to turn this world around. It's about time we start to make it the dream we've always known. It's about time we start to live it as a family of man. It's about time. It's about changes. It's about time. It's about peace and it's about plenty. It's about time. It's about you and me together. It's about time. So we're at that point of the show that is the most nerve-wracking for me. So I will tell you, this is the song that John Denver sang to end every concert. It's a song about his best friend, his guitar. He learned to play guitar because his grandma Swope bought him a guitar when he was 13 years old on the promise that he would learn to play. And it was an old Ethel Gibson jazz guitar. And he played and he played. He wrote a lot of songs on that guitar. And then he lost it. And in every book that I've read about him, it's never, ever revealed how he lost it. But what he did was he celebrated when he found it again. He was on tour in California. He was playing a six-night stand at the Universal Amphitheater. And somehow in his travels, he came across a guitar. And in interviews, he said, yeah, I took it back to my hotel room, and we spent hours talking and catching up on what had happened to each other. And you know, he made light of it. And he said, out of that conversation came this song. Now, what he's really telling in this song is that his guitar was his only friend. The father, the Air Force officer, a different base every year. He went to a different school every single year when he was growing up. And his only companion, the only constant he had in his life, was that guitar. So he wrote this song, and it's called This Old Guitar, and I'm going to play it for you. Now, this is the part that's nerve-wracking for me. When I'm done playing it, you're going to stand up and you're going to applaud, because you're Minnesota nice. Yeah. You are. I know this. I know this. What I don't know is you're going to stand up, applaud, and then you're going to walk out and make a hasty retreat. Or if you think we might have one or two more songs up our sleeve, in which case you'll stand up and you'll apply just a little bit longer, just in case. So, and I never know what you're going to do until it actually happens. And you're like, oh, there they go. This old guitar. This old guitar taught me to sing a love song, showed me how to laugh and how to cry. Introduced me to some friends of mine, brightened up some days, helped me make it through those lonely nights. What a friend to have on a cold and lonely night. This old guitar gave me my lovely lady. It opened up her eyes and ears to me, brought us close together, and I guess it broke her heart and opened up a place for us to be. What a lovely place and a lovely space to be. This old guitar gave me my life, my living, all the things you know I love to do. Serenade the stars that shine from a sunny mountainside, most of all to sing my songs for you. I love to sing my songs for you. Yes, I do, you know. Couple more? Will you help me out with them? I'm gonna hold you this. You're gonna have to sing along on these things. Almost heaven, West Virginia. Mama. an old country boy, big ass hat. Early to rise, early in the sack. Thank God I'm a country boy. Well, a simple kind of life never did me no harm. Raising me a family, working on a farm. Days are all filled with an easy country charm. Thank God I'm a country boy. Well, I got me a fine wife, I got me old fiddle. When the sun coming up, I got cakes on the griddle. Life ain't nothing but a funny, funny riddle. Thank God I'm a country boy. Well, work's all done and the sun's setting low. I pull off the fiddle and I rosin up the boat. The kids are asleep, so I keep them kind of low. Thank God I'm a country boy. I play Sally Gooden all day if I could, but the Lord and my wife wouldn't think it very good. Fiddle when I can and I work when I should. Thank God I'm a country boy. Well, I got me a fine wife, I got me a fiddle. When the sun's going up, I got cakes on the griddle. Life ain't nothing but a funny, funny riddle. Thank God I'm a country boy. Them money hungry fools. Rather have my fiddle and my farming tools. Thank God I'm a country boy. Yeah, city boy riding in a black limousine. A lot of sad people thinking that's a mighty game. Son, let me tell you now exactly what I mean. Thank God I'm a country boy. Well, I got me a fine wife, I got me old fiddle. When the sun coming up, I got cakes on the griddle. Life ain't nothing but a funny, funny riddle. Thank God I'm a country boy. Yeah, I fiddled with my daddy till the day he died. Took me by the hand, held me close to his side. So live a good life and play the fiddle with pride. My daddy taught me young how to hunt, how to whittle. Taught me how to work and play a tune on the fiddle. Taught me how to work and give just a little. Thank God I'm a country boy. I got me a fine wife, I got me old fiddle. When the sun's coming up, I got gigs on the griddle. Life ain't nothing but a funny, funny riddle.
Woo!
Thank you, Little Falls. Thank God I'm a country boy, yeah. You guys have been great. Come see us again.
Thank you. You've been wonderful.